What's up, everybody? Mike McIntyre here, back with a brand new video. I am super, super excited. I hope you're having a great day. Please sit down, enjoy, and I am so excited for this video. Let's get that intro rolling and get right into it. First off, I need to give a quick shout out to Evangelista Sports for hooking me up with these boots for this review video. If you guys are interested in any sort of Puma gear or any footballing gear, be sure to check out that first link down below in the description. This video would not be possible without them, so show them love, check that link out down below in the description, and let's get into the video. In front of me, I have the Puma Future 18.1 in the yellow, red, and black colorway. This is one of the most exciting boots I think that have come out in the last little while. I love this color. I think they're phenomenal. So we're gonna unbox the video, talk a little bit about the tech specs and colorway, and slip them on to talk about sizing. So let's get right into it. Okay guys, so there's a quick look at the Puma Future 18.1 in the yellow, red, and black colorway. Inside the box, you do get the boots themselves, and they include an extra set of laces. If you'd like to swap them out for these orange ones, you can do that. But other than that, there are no other extras. Now, this boot is absolutely phenomenal. I think it's one of the most interesting releases of the last few months, and it's one that I actually would love to purchase and actually wear on feet. So we're gonna talk quickly about tech specs, we're gonna talk about color, and we're gonna get them on so we can see what they fit and feel like. So first off, obviously the color, this is a very bright boot. We have this sort of Volt Electric yellow as the base. You can see that sort of highlight throughout the boot. We have these sort of red accents in the Puma stripe, in the sort of sock-like knitted material in there. On the back, you have that big cat in the red color, as well as the Future logo right there on this sort of tab right here. On the bottom, you do get a little Puma accent right there, and that's pretty much it for the red. You have Netfit right here and another Puma Big Cat right there. But other than that, there's not too much red. It's kind of cool how it sort of fades into this black in the heel. I think that looks really, really good. And the graphic overall just looks really, really clean in my opinion, and I love the way the boot looks. As far as actual upper material and tech specs, the boot is made from Puma's EvoKnit sock, so this area up here is very, very elasticated. It's a knitted boot like all the other modern boots nowadays, so the underlying material is this knit. It's very, very soft from out of the box. Not quite as soft as the Puma EvoPower Vigors, simply because they have this net fit system right here. So essentially, these are these sort of texturized, quite firm loops, I suppose, that allow you to lace the boot up in any which way you want. From this seam right here until this seam right here, you can't actually use these holes at the front. They're not really allowing you to lace them, but you can use the couple of lace holes in there. You can use any of the lace holes that you see in between this area right here, as well as the same on the outside. So anything from about here to the back portion up here, this whole sort of stripe, you can choose from any hole you'd like there. And they're very, very tight. They're not like these loose things that you can, you know, get at quite easily. They are quite tight to the boot itself to give you this very seamless feel. It's a very, very interesting concept, and given that a lot of boots are taking away laces, I find it very, very interesting that Puma is adding a customizable lacing system for a player to sort of dial in their preferred setup, if you will. So it's a very, very interesting upper material. Again, sock-like material. It is an EvoKnit, or a knitted upper, I should say, made from Puma's EvoKnit base. And then they've just coated it with a sort of texturized material, or a very thin sort of synthetic material, just to give the boot a little bit of durability. This one does have a little bit of heightened collar right here, but it's not over the top. Once again, it does fit the ankle quite well. And if anything, it kind of reminds me of some of the more Adidas-like collars. It kind of looks a little bit like the Nemesis. I'll have to see how it feels as I try them on, just to be 100% sure, but I don't think there'll be any issues with this type of collar right here. The sole plate has changed ever so slightly from the EvoPower line. Once again, you do have a very slight combination of conical and bladed studs, so this will be good on pretty much any type of field nowadays. You have the conical studs up here in the forefoot, a couple of bladed studs right here, just to give you a little bit more extra stability. And instead of a gradual stability frame, we have this new design right here. So again, it's a PVAX plastic material, providing you with flexibility in the forefoot and stiffness towards the heel with these stiffener bars right here. In my opinion, I do find the studs to be a little bit longer than some of the other cleats. If you look at these sort of conical ones right here, I do find them to be a little bit more aggressive and a little longer, but I don't think that will be too big of an issue simply because they are conical. So that is pretty much it, guys, for the sort of unboxing and review of the tech specs and the performance characteristics of the boot itself. I'm gonna slip them on so we can talk a little bit about fit and feel, and what sizing is like. So please stick around and we'll get into the next part of the video. All right guys, so there's a quick look at the Puma Future 18.1s on feet. These are very, very comfortable from right out of the box. The collar is a little bit different than some of the other ones, but I don't think it's a big deal. I think you'll get used to it quite quickly. The upper is super soft, but again, it's not quite as soft in my opinion as the Evo Power Vigors, but I think that is simply because of the net fit system. They had to add another layer, allowing you to customize the actual fit and feel of the boot itself. So there is a little bit more layers to the upper itself. But once these things soften up, I almost guarantee you that they're gonna be as comfortable as the Puma Evo Power Vigors. I would suggest going true to size. Sometimes Puma are a little bit different in their sizing, but with this boot, I strongly suggest going true to size. I've always gone true to size in my Puma boots, and I don't have any regrets. So I think they're gonna soften up. They're gonna fit very, very comfortably. They feel really, really good from out of the box, and they're only gonna soften up even more as you play in them, just given the nature of the materials used. So this is gonna be a fantastic boot. I really think this is one that you should not overlook. If you're interested in these, please, again, check out that first link down below in the description. Check out Evangelista Sports. You can find these Puma Futures on there. Find them in your size and pick up a pair for yourself. They're a great boot, and I can't wait to get my hands on my own pair. These are phenomenal, and I don't have enough good things to say about them. So I'm super, super excited to be able to bring you this video today. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like down below. Leave a comment if you have any kind of questions. And this was Mike McIntyre with All Things Sports. I'm signing off for now. Hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.